Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, I'll be showing you how to install Proxmox onto a Raspberry Pi. Before we get started, you will need to be running a 64-bit version of Raspberry Pi OS Lite. You will also need a static IP address for your Raspberry Pi. The best way to set a static IP is through your router. Once you are ready, open up the terminal on your Raspberry Pi or SSH into it. The first thing we want to do is run sudo apt update to update the package list. Next, type sudo apt upgrade-y to upgrade any out-of-date packages. Next, we want to ensure kel is installed to your system by typing sudo apt install kel. If prompted, type y and hit enter to continue with the installation. Next, verify the local IP address of your Raspberry Pi by typing hostname-i and pressing enter. In this example, you can tell that our IP address is 192.168.0.32. We will need this local IP address for this next step. Begin editing the host file by typing sudo nano /etc/hosts. Within this file, navigate to the bottom line. It should read 127.0.1.1 plus your host name. The bit you want to replace is at the front of this line. You want to replace the IP address with the static IP of your Raspberry Pi. In our case, that will be 192.168.0.32. Once you're done, press Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter to save and quit. We can verify our IP address has been updated by typing hostname --IP-address and pressing Enter. In our example, you can see that our IP address is now reporting as 192.168.0.32. Proxmox will require us to use the root user and not our default user. Before we can do that, we must set a password for the root user. To do this, type sudo passwd /root. You will then be required to enter a new password twice. Ensure that this password is secure as the root user has full control over your operating system. Your next step is to use kel to download the GPG key for the Proxmox repository we are relying on. To do this, type kel --L, followed by the URL shown on your screen. You'll then need to use the pipe symbol, followed by sudo t, then /usr/share/keyrings/pveport.gpg. Followed by the greater than symbol /dev/null. With the GPG key now saved, we can move on to adding the repository itself. We do this by typing echo double quote dev square bracket open arch equals arm64 space signed -by equals /user/share/keyring/pveport.gpg close square bracket. We then need to specify the URL shown on the screen, which will link to the repository itself. After the URL, type in bookworm /port double quote pipe symbol sudo t /etc/apt/sources.list.d/pveport.list. As we made changes to the available repositories, we need to update the package list again by typing in sudo apt update. With the repository finally added, we can begin setting up Proxmox itself. The first part of this process is to install the if-up-down-to package. To install this package, all you need to do is type in sudo apt install if-up-down-to. If prompted, type y and press enter to continue with the installation. If you see an error stating another instance of this program is already running, you may need to delete a temporary file. You can delete this file by typing sudo rm/tmp /if-up-down-to --first-install and then pressing enter. This isn't required in all cases, but it doesn't hurt to run it anyway. All we need to do after running that command is to run sudo apt install if-up-down-to again. As Proxmox relies on a different networking stack, we will need to make some changes to our network interfaces. To make these changes, edit the interfaces file by typing sudo nano /etc/network/interfaces. First thing we want to specify in this file is our Ethernet connection. To do this, type auto space ETH0. Due to how Proxmox works, we don't want this to grab an IP address. To do that, type iface ETH0 inet manual. Next, we'll be creating a bridge that will be used by Proxmox to interact with your Ethernet connection. To start this virtual bridge, type in auto space VMBR0. We also want this virtual network to be manually controlled, so type in iface space VMBR0 space inet space manual. With it being in manual mode, we now need to specify the IP address that this network interface will use. Type in address, followed by the static IP that you have assigned to your Raspberry Pi. In our case, this will be 192.168.0.32. The next thing we need to do is specify the gateway or router that we need to be connecting to. To do this, type in gateway space followed by the IP address of your router. In our case, this is 192.168.0.1. Next, specify the netmask as 255.255.255.0. We next need to get this interface to bridge our Ethernet connection by typing in bridge-ports space ETH0. With that done, we will want to disable the STP protocol by typing in bridge-STP space off. The final thing we'll want to do is disable the bridge forwarding delay by typing in bridge-FD space 0. With all those changes done, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter. To ensure the networking changes are working, restart your Raspberry Pi by typing in sudo space reboot and hitting Enter. Once your Raspberry Pi is finished rebooting, we can move on to installing Proxmox itself. To do this, type in sudo apt install proxmox-ve, then postfix, then open dash iscsi and then pve hyphen edk2 hyphen firmware hyphen aarch64 and then hitting enter. If prompted, type in y and then hit enter to continue with the installation of Proxmox to your Raspberry Pi. This process will take a while, but don't walk away as there's a few things you'll need to do during the installation process. The first pause during the installation requires us to configure postfix. For this video, we'll just be sticking with local only as we don't plan on sending mail from our own Proxmox server. You will next be asked to set a system mail name. This defaults to the host name of your Raspberry Pi. This is what we will be sticking to for this tutorial and we will just be pressing enter. With postfix configured, Proxmox will finish installing. There'll be one last prompt you'll need to do right at the end of this installation process. Proxmox will now attempt to replace the repository that we set up earlier. The default behavior is the one we want, which stops it from replacing it. Press enter to stick with the default. You have now successfully set up Proxmox on your Raspberry Pi. For the next step, we'll need to open up a web browser, so we'll be moving away from our Raspberry Pi. With a web browser open, you want to go to https://, followed by your IP address of your Raspberry Pi. You'll then want to write a colon again, followed by the port number 8006. As Proxmox is using a self-signed certificate, you'll get a connection is not private warning. Hit the advance button, followed by the proceed link, to continue with using the Proxmox web interface. Now, to make use of the Proxmox interface, you'll need to type in the username root, and then type in the password you set earlier within this video. You'll get a pop-up about not having a valid subscription. This isn't required to use Proxmox, so you can safely press the OK button to continue. At this point, you have successfully gotten Proxmox running on your Raspberry Pi and also accessed its web interface. If you liked this video, please be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.